Welcome to AminAcademy.com. In linear programming, let us discuss about its advantages, limitations, and some definitions. Advantage of linear programming techniques. The main advantage of linear programming techniques are given below. It indicates how the available resources can be used in the best way. That means, it helps in attaining the optimum use of productive factors. Linear programming indicates how a manager can utilize his productive factors most effectively by a better solution and distribution of these elements. For example, more efficient use of manpower and machines can be obtained by the use of linear programming. It helps in attaining the optimum use of the productive resources and manpower. It is very helpful to improve production rate. It improves the quality of decisions. So the decision makers can easily get some improvements in quality and decision making. It reflects the drawbacks of the production process. That means whatever the drawbacks will come in future can also predict by using the techniques of linear programming. The necessary modification of the mathematical solution is also possible by using linear programming. It helps in re-evaluation of basic plan with changing conditions. Here, day by day, the conditions of the environments will change. Due to that, the production process can be changed to improve productivity. It improves the quality of decisions. The individual who makes use of linear programming methods become more objective than subjective. The individual having a clear picture of the relationship within the basic equations, inequalities, and constraints can have a better idea about the problems and its solutions. It can go a long way to improving the knowledge and skill of the tomorrow's executives. Next, we will discuss about some limitations of linear programming. Even though the linear programming have many advantages, also at the same time, it has some limitation of its extent. It is not simple to determine the objective functions mathematically in LPP. It is difficult to specify the constraints even after the determination of the objective functions. There is possibility that the objective function and constraints may or may not be directly defined by linear in the equality of equations. That means both functions should be linear. Mostly, the functions cannot be in linear. So we have to make it possible linear way, then we can make it linear programming to develop it. For large problems having many limitations and constraints, the computational difficulties are enormous, even when assistance of large digital computers is available. According to the linear programming problem, the solution variable can have any value, whereas sometimes it happens that some of the variables can have only integral values. The model does not take into account the effect of time. The operation research team must define the objective functions and constraints which can change overnight due to internal as well as external factors. Many times, it is not possible to express both the objective functions and constraints in linear form. The main problem while solving LPP is to determine the suitable coefficient value at each step. The assumption made for LPP are not realistic since they will be taken based on the element involved in the given situation. The solution obtained in LPP may not be integers all the time. So it's a fractional value, as decimal values also come, so it give some difficulties. Now let us discuss about characteristics of linear programming. The following are the five characteristics of the linear programming problem. First, constraints. Constraint: the limitation should be expressed in the mathematical form regarding the resources. Here, suppose the constraints look at this linear programming. Suppose maximize maximize that equal 4x1 plus 3x2. Suppose it's a maximize problem. Subject: subject 2, 5x1 plus 2x2 is greater or equal to 15. Second one is 7x1 plus 3x2 is greater or equal, lesser or equal to 6. And x2 are greater or equal to 0. Here, these are the constraints for maximizing z, 4x1 plus 3x2. These are the constraint, and x1, x2 are non-negative constraints. Here, linearity: the relationship between two or more variables in the function must be linear. Means that the degree of the variable is 1. Other than the linear, we cannot do the linear programming for this particular conditions. Finiteness: there should be finite and infinite input and output numbers. In case if the function has infinite factors, the optimal solution is not feasible. So to make it feasible, that finiteness must be considered. That means there should be finite number of solutions. Non-negativity: the variable value should be positive or zero. It should not be in negative value. That means x1, y1 should not be in negative values. Decision of variables: the decision variable will decide the output. It gives the ultimate solution of the problem. For any problem, the first step is to identify the decision variables. You have to consider the decision variable first to programming the linear, to make it linear programming. About the solution, we'll discuss something. Feasible solution: a feasible solution to your linear program is a solution that satisfies all constraints. An optimal solution is a linear programming is the feasible solution with the largest objective function value for maximization problem. Further, suppose x is have x1, x2, x3 like xn. A real number of that satisfy all the constraints of the general linear programming problem is called the solution of the linear general linear programming problem is called the solution of the general linear programming problems. For example, x have the solution 5, 0 is a solution of the following linear programming problem. So we had to get a particular value for that variables. That is x equal here 5 comma 0 is the particular value that is called a solution of this programming. Further detail we will continue next videos. We have done. Please subscribe our YouTube channel.